Hello world, welcome to a new video of Bidev Tours channel.
Bidev Tours is a tour operator located in Ecuador. For those of you who don't know it yet, our focus is to show Ecuador to the world and to Ecuadorians as well, show the culture and nature of this rich country. Of course, always taking into account sustainability of the territories and their cultures. On this occasion, we are releasing a new format. Culture is about people living in an area, and on this occasion, I want to show you, as I have done in other videos, humans of Cuenca. Credits to Capture Joseph for this title.
By the way, Humans of Cuenca is the name of a series run in Cuenca by another YouTuber. The name of this YouTuber is Joseph, and his YouTube channel is Capture Joseph. In Humans of Cuenca, he interviews people living in Cuenca, Cuencanos and people from all around the world as well. If you're interested in life in Cuenca, in people in Cuenca, what to do in Cuenca, and even in other parts of Ecuador, I highly encourage you to visit his channel. His series of videos are very enjoyable, and you will certainly learn a lot about Cuenca and its people.
Cuenca is a city where many cultures from all around the world have gathered, and that makes Cuenca richer. We are on the verge of the Cuenca's Fair Book 2022. The Book Fair of Cuenca, Feria del Libro de Cuenca, will start on November 22. And I am with an author that will be presenting his book on this fair, Paul Anthony. Paul, well, he has a very interesting story to tell, as many people here have. I will let Paul introduce himself and tell us about his story that he is telling to the world in his book that has just been published. Okay, Paul, let us know and let the world know, where do you come from and what in the end brought you to Cuenca?
Okay, thank you very much, Luis. I appreciate the opportunity, and it's great to be on your show. I've seen your previous videos, liked them a lot, so glad to be here. Okay, so the story of why we're here today is that I wrote a book. It was recently published on Amazon. It's called His Mother's Son, Memoirs of an Accidental Man. It's available in both paperback and ebook form. And this book has a very special connection with the city of Cuenca. It's not about Cuenca, but it came together and was literally born and produced here in Cuenca. So I want to tell you a little bit about that. The book itself, as you can tell from the subtitle, is a memoir. It's about my life, for the first 60 years of my life. It deals with a few main themes. For me, it was escaping a past that seemed accidental to me in search of an authentic life. An important theme is the resolution of a conflicted relationship with my mother, and also the importance of my passion for the natural world and how my travels and mountaineering and rock climbing and sailing and things like that were helpful in the healing process for me. So anyway, let's get on with the story of how the book relates to Cuenca. I think it's a good story because it's descriptive of what Cuenca is all about. Cuenca is a city that has the feel of a small town. It feels tightly knit. People are very friendly. They know each other. It has a very small town feel. It's great. But it also, at the same time, has connections to the entire world. And that's partly due to the fact that there are people from Cuenca and from Ecuador that live in the United States. There's a lot of people, expats from the United States and other countries, that live here in Cuenca and throughout Ecuador. And there's also the important fact that it seems the whole world wants to visit Ecuador. They start with wanting to see the Galapagos, but I think a lot of them wind up wanting to see Cuenca, Vilcabamba, the coast, the Orient. There's a lot to see here, a lot to do. So I arrived in Cuenca on the 21st of March, 2018. And the very first day that I was in Cuenca, I made some connections, or one particular connection that would affect the trajectory of this project with the creation of the book. I didn't know it at the time, but here's what happened. I left my hotel room, I walked through Parque de la Madre, I went up the stairs across the Tomabamba River and up to Calle Larga, and I immediately see this restaurant that looked really interesting, and I was hungry. I went into Café Libre, I met Paul Flores, the head chef and the proprietor, the first of many amazing meals that were prepared by Paul. Only within maybe a week or 2 weeks after that, he introduced me to his sister, Cristina. Cristina, at the time and still, is the proprietor of independent Spanish school. And I needed help learning Spanish, and I've gotten great assistance from Cristina. She also introduced me to a woman designer here in town named Dianola Vázquez. Dianola is the proprietor of Subte Design. She is the one who designed the book. Let me grab this so you can see it.
Please.
There's the cover. Dianola, of course, designed not only the cover, the back cover, the spine, located all of the illustrations inside the book, did all the design aspects. She has really a great imagination. So that was an extraordinary and important connection to make right there. The next piece of the puzzle was the illustrator, Diego Molina, the man who created the art for the cover, also created the illustrations that are inside the book. He was introduced to me by Dianola. So there's another piece of the puzzle. Fairly recently, within the last, I'd say 3 or 4 months, I was also put in touch by Cristina Flores with Richard James. Richard James is the marketing consultant who has taken control of the launch of the book. He's created the website, which is authorpaulanthony.com. And he's also been really instrumental in figuring out what our ad campaign will be and every other thing, every other aspect involved in the marketing of the book. Richard, incidentally, who has a business called richardwritescopy.com, he is originally from India. He grew up in Singapore. He went to the university in London, and then he moved here to Cuenca. So I think that's a pretty good example of the attraction that Cuenca has all over the world, and is a pretty good example also of the variety of people and variety of cultures and experiences that you will find here in Cuenca.
Let us know 3 things why people should read your book, or why people would be eager to read your book.
Okay, I think that one of the themes that this book deals with, something that I experienced and I think a lot of people experience, is that feeling of not fitting in. And when I started to write the book, I noticed that I kept writing this little phrase, that I didn't fit in. And as I was doing that, I thought, well, that's probably true for a lot of people. Because we live in a very modern, fast-paced age, an industrial society, and it can be very difficult to make connections with people. So that was, I think, is a theme that all of us have to deal with. Also in the sense that we need to not just fit in, but we want to find the place where we fit in. We want to find or make our place in the world. That's one of the key things every individual has to do. My story is a story of finding that place of fitting in. The other theme I think that will affect a lot of people, or that a lot of people can relate to, is the experience of having family relationships that are, shall I say, suboptimal, that aren't what they should be. I don't mean you necessarily were abused or anything like that, but again, because of the kind of culture that we live in, because of the fast-paced technological world we live in, a lot of times the fundamental relationships that we have in our families are strained. And this is something that we end up dealing with for our entire life, or at least to the point that we're able to resolve it. That's another really strong element in this book, a really important theme in my book. Now, the third thing that I would say is the important theme is my relationship with nature. This is also something that affects most people in the world today. Most people in industrialized countries, they don't live out in the countries, they live in the city. And so we suffer as a result of being cut off from nature. That's where we come from, even though it may seem foreign just a place that you would visit for an afternoon in the park or for a weekend in the mountains or the desert. That's the place where human beings lived and evolved for many, many centuries prior to the advent of agriculture and the rise of cities. This was something that I found was a refuge for me and a way that I was able to improve my health, not just physically, but mentally and psychologically. And that was a really important factor in the progress that I made from an accidental past to an authentic life. So those I would say would be the three main themes of the book and three things in my life that I think are also things that are very common in the lives of most people nowadays.
Well, would you say that Cuenca, the landscapes or the weather, is there something here, whatever it is, inspire you a little bit to go ahead beyond the partners you could find, something that was here that inspired you?
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up, because that's another aspect of Cuenca that I think is really important, not only just in the day-to-day life and the enjoyment of the city, but yes, as an inspiration for anybody who has a creative impulse or an appreciation for the arts. Cuenca has a very rich and long history. And part of that history and tradition is the arts. You can see that right away. Everybody knows that the Catedral Nuevo is the center, in the center of the town. It's a beautiful example of colonial architecture. And typical architecture of this type is the reason why Cuenca is named a UNESCO heritage site. The commitment of the city today is also an obvious one. The city is definitely committed to the arts. It has programs to publish books. It has tours. It maintains galleries, museums, historical buildings, plazas. It hires artists to create paintings, sculptures, that are throughout the town. It even has really nice graffiti. So every aspect of the town. In fact, while we're on that topic, I want to mention that on the 22nd of November at 10:30 in the morning, the Alcaldía, the city of Cuenca, has provided a really beautiful venue, the auditorium of the Escuela Central, very near Parque Calderon in the center of town, for the presentation of the book. We intend to be live streaming that on Facebook as well, but it's open to the public, and we'll be basically launching the book to the public, making it known to everybody here in Cuenca, and of course to the world through the live streaming on Facebook. Yeah, I think my whole experience with the book, living in the town here, has been really great. I'm a pretty good spokesperson and advertisement, I think, for Cuenca. I've been here for 4.5 years. I'm still discovering all kinds of new things. I'm meeting lots of great people. I have a lot of great friends here. I'm happy every day with the decision that I made to get out of the place where I was and to come to a better place. And it goes virtually without saying, but I'll say it anyway, Cuenca also boasts a really great climate. It boasts a lot of variety in terms of its geology, its landforms, in terms of the mountains, the coast, the Galapagos Islands, the Amazon Basin. I mean, the weather is fantastic here. The food is just the best all year round. You've got every kind of fruit and vegetable that you could ask for. The restaurants here in Cuenca are amazing. The variety is great. It's not just the comidas típicas, the Ecuadorian food or the Cuencana food here, but it's all of the restaurants that have sprung up as a result of the influence of immigrants. We've got not just Peruvian or Argentinian or Colombian restaurants, but we've got beer houses, fresh brewed beer from Czechoslovakia. We've got German beer. We've got, of course, local artisanal beer as well. Got really good Indian food here. So Thai food, I mean, I could go on and on if I could remember them all right now, but that's another aspect of the town that I think makes it really comfortable, really interesting to live in. And you feel, again, like you're in a small town. I see people all the time that I know, but at the same time, you feel that you're part of the whole world and you're getting a taste of all of those cultures.
But what would you say are the main differences that you see between US culture, being grown up in a US culture, and now living in Ecuadorian culture in South America, in Cuenca culture, which is actually Andean culture?
Okay, well, now that's a big question, and there are some definite differences, and there were a lot of changes that happened while I lived in the United States, because I was born in 1954. I left the United States in 2018. So during that period of time, things changed a lot in the United States. But I would say if I were to take a snapshot of Cuencan culture or Ecuadorian culture and US culture and compare them, the thing that I have noticed the most in coming to Cuenca has been that it is different than in the United States, but what's the same is what I remember from my childhood, that when I was a young person in the United States, people were much more friendly, they were much more concerned and involved with their neighbors, and that's something that I really like about Cuencan culture. Every day that I'm walking around, especially in El Centro, I'm seeing people that are stopping on the street or the sidewalk or in the park, and they're greeting each other, they're talking, they're taking time to catch up, to enjoy the company of their friends. I also note that there are is a higher priority in Cuencan culture for friendship, for the family. I mean, that to me is something that's been missing or that we've been losing in the United States and probably in most city environments and most technological cultures. Now, Cuenca, it's on the same planet Earth as everybody else. And so the influences of technology, the influences of the money culture and the global economy, they're obvious here and they affect everybody. But at the same time, there is much more of that traditional influence, and it's something that I find to be really refreshing and really comforting. And I would say for myself personally, I have made a lot of friends here, and those friends are not other expats. Those friends are Cuencanos or perhaps immigrants from other places. For example, I have friends that are from Venezuela, I have friends that are from Colombia, I have friends that are from the Middle East. I have several friends now that are from India. These are all people that I met here. And then there's plenty of friends, you know, from here in Cuenca. So this is an aspect that to me is really important. I have more close friends here. I'm more closely involved with them in terms of business and in terms of socializing than I was with friends back in the United States. So this is an entire aspect of my life that I consider to be way, way better here than it was in the United States. And really the only thing that I have been, I won't say required to do, I would say motivated to do, is to continually work on improving my language skills, because the better that I can speak Spanish and understand Spanish, the easier it is to communicate. Although there's plenty of folks here too that are either fluent in English or that are, you know, working on that. So communications is really not a problem.
What would your recommendation to newcomers in Cuenca be?
Well, okay, if I'm talking to a newcomer, it's going to depend a little bit on whether they're just here on a vacation for a week or two, or whether they're, you know, going to come down and spend maybe their summer vacation for two or three
months. For people who would like to live here.
People who are going to immigrate here or thinking about that. I would say, yeah, come down here, check it out, experience it for yourself. And then I would also say, don't just prepare to come here to live, prepare for your visit too. And that means do some research. We have places like Gringo Post where you can see a list of questions from people every day. And a lot of those questions are things that could easily have been answered before the person came here. So if you're going to be coming down here, know that the trail is well marked. In fact, it's not a trail, it's more like a highway. And so you can find out a lot about it before you come here. But when you come here, just think about what you really want from the experience, what you want to get out of it, but also what you want to put into it. And I would say, yeah, spend some time doing some research, spend some time getting ready to come down. And I think that every little bit of preparation that you do will enhance the experience that you have here. I would also say, since I was just talking about language, that be aware of the fact that no matter how many people there are here that are friendly and inviting and that speak some English or plenty of English, that you will want to assume responsibility to enhance your experience here on all levels by being able to the best of your ability to understand the language and to speak the language. That's going to be something that, again, I would encourage you to do, but to not look at it as a requirement or a burden or a job, but as an opportunity. Language is a bridge between cultures. It's a doorway, a window into other experiences and ways of living. And every little bit that you can learn and do and that makes you more comfortable here is going to enhance the experience of living here. So that would be my main advice, I would say.
Thanks. Yeah. I just would like to add that every week I learn something new about from people here in Cuenca or even regarding the nature in Cuenca. Every week I learn something new as I meet new people. And well, today I have learn many things from Paul, and as he says, you are always learning something. And I think here in Cuenca, the authorities are doing something to really help improve creativity, arts, and have this quality of life that I wish that all of Ecuador had, because we still have many issues. And well, that's why I told you in a video, that's why I started this tour operator, because I would like the world to know how things can be improved and how you could live in a good way. Well, little by little, learn something new, and I hope you join me in this journey and you join us, people who live in Cuenca, who live in Ecuador, who are part of this country, in how we make a better world through the years. That's what the goal of many of us here is. And maybe we won't see big things, but if we do something now, our children, maybe grandchildren, will see. Thank you, Paul. Thank you for all you have said about Cuenca, about Ecuador. And the more you know the stories of people coming to Ecuador, the more you say, you know, we have so much potential and I want to do something with this potential and transmit that to the world, because all the world has issues. Ecuador has its issues. Colombia has its issues. Peru has its issues. Let's talk about the neighbors. And I know where you listen to me from. If you are not in Ecuador, the place where you are, you have your own issues. But eventually you know that there is a way to make the world better and that you can live in a better way. And that's what I want to do, starting by Cuenca, you know, eventually. Maybe in 20 years we watch this and something was made. Who knows about that? Well, you have to dream big to achieve big things. Like this story, I know it's a big story, and I hope you are very successful with it, that it gets far.
Thank you.
And I think this could turn a series, or this is a series, the first one of a series, so I wish you success.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it, Luis.
Thank you for joining us today, and for joining More of Culture in Cuenca, More of Nature History. Remember to subscribe to the channel. And remember, if you want to get to know Cuenca, come here. Visit No Culture Nature. You may always contact us, send an email to info@wildevtours.com, and always please feel free to leave a comment here. If you're interested in knowing more about Paul, about his story too, I'm leaving you the links in the description of this video about his partners, colleagues, and eventually you will be knowing more people through this channel and other content creators who will make things soon together. And stay tuned. Thank you very much, and see you in the next occasion. Bye bye.